I never thought that this is where I'd settle down. I thought I'd die an old man back in my hometown. They gave me this plot of land, me and some other men, for a job well done. There's a big white house, sits on a hill just up the road. The man inside, he cried the day they brought me home. They folded up a flag and told my mom and dad, "We're proud of your son." And I'm proud to be on this peaceful piece of property. I'm on sacred ground and I'm in the best company. I'm thankful for those, thankful for the things I've done. I can rest in peace, I'm one of the chosen ones. I made it to Arlington. I remember Daddy brought me here when I was 8. We searched all day to find out where my granddad lay. And when we finally found that cross, he said, "Son, this is what it cost to keep us free." Now here I am, 1,000 stones away from him. He recognized me on the first day I came in, and it gave me a chill when he clicked his heels and saluted me. And I'm proud to be on this peaceful piece of property. I'm on sacred ground and I'm in the best of company.
Stretching out below, land, blessed motherland, the place where I was born. Scars, yeah, she's got her scars. Sometimes it starts to worry me, 'cause lose, I don't wanna lose sight of who we are.
Okay, who are you?
I am Frank August Risto, Sergeant Retired U.S. Army.
Why did you join the armed forces?
Because I thought I was a bad SOB and I wanted to help out and make a difference.
Why did you pick the service branch you joined?
It sees the most action.
Okay. What do you recall, or excuse me, do you recall your first days in the service? What did it feel like?
Yes. Like a shaved monkey in space. It was highly dramatic. In retrospect, it was pretty awesome, but very scary and pretty challenging.
Tell me about your boot camp or training experience. How did you get through it?
That was a rough one. I really strived and did well at boot camp, but I sustained an injury when I took a M16 buttstock to the head, and then I also hit a concrete wall pretty hard and had to have a surgery. So I was almost graduated, but then because I had to go to the hospital, I had to start all the way back over at week one. So I did basic twice. So I was a stud.
Were you awarded any medals or citations? If so, how did you get them?
Many. I think three. Our comms are called Army Commendation Medals. Just trying to pick out the one that I did earn the War on Terrorism Expeditious Medal for Valor, because I was in such a bad area. first to get her down there. So that one was pretty cool.
How did you stay in touch with your family?
Back at the FOB when I was overseas. That is back at the forward operating base in TK, Afghanistan. They had a small computer lab that I could get it to every once in a while, so I could send messages.
Do you recall the day your service ended? If so, where were you?
Well, I officially left active duty in, I believe, October of 2012 or 13, but it was the day I got let out of the hospital out east and got to come back home to Minnesota.
Okay. Did you make any close friends while you were in the service?
I did. I don't keep in contact with many of them, but I did.
Did you join a veterans organization?
I have joined several.
What did you go to do as a career after the military?
Grunt. I started back my old construction company that I didn't think I'd have to do again. There's no going back to my Army job from the injuries.
How did your service and experience affect your life?
Drastically. Terribly.
Is there anything that you'd like to add that we have not covered in this interview?
Don't join the Army or the Marines. If you want to serve your country and get a good education and make some money, join the Air Force, the Navy, where they use your smarts and they got way better equipment, and they don't stick us out in the desert in the middle of nowhere with no support.
Hoorah. Did you join any veterans organizations?
I did. Joined the DAV. A lifetime member, joined the Legion and the VFW. I haven't kept up on those ones because it costs money every year, so I haven't done those anymore. But also the Wounded Warrior Project and the Wounded Warrior Guide Service, volunteered for both of those. And Mission Continues, St. Paul Branch.
If tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom and they can't take that away. I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston and New York to LA, well, there's pride in every American heart.